Okay, so I have a whole playlist of videos about working about Git and GitHub. If you don't know anything about Git and GitHub, you might want to go and look at some of those. This will assume basic knowledge. What I'm going to show you is, if you're on a new machine, hopefully you might have set this up already, but what if right now for the first time you are using Git from the command line and you also want to work with GitHub? So I've actually already installed Git. I can see that because I type Git and it shows me a bunch of things. It doesn't say Git is unknown, but if you need to install Git, you can just go to git-scm and download the latest version for your operating system. And then back here, got all this crazy stuff open. Let me close it. I can start doing Git commands. Like, for example, if I make a directory, that's make a directory like new project, and I do cd new project, and I say git init, that's how it actually makes a Git repository inside of a folder. Oh, look at this. All of a sudden, it says, look, git and master. And I can do things like git branch. And sometimes I don't like to use the word master. I just use like source or something. So I could say git branch source. Okay, actually, I haven't committed or made any files. So it's not going to let me make the branch without any files. So let me show you. And this is a bit out of scope, but it's fine, actually, because we can tie some things together. Like, for example, I'm going to say code dot open up this directory with Visual Studio Code. Then I'm going to make a new file, and I'm going to call it, sketch.js, because I'm working on some JavaScript code. And I'm just going to put like function setup in it. I'm going to hit save. And look at this. When I come back here, you can see now that that file is in there. And look at this. Actually, this changed. I think this is indicating something to me, like there's a new file or something. So now I want to say git commit. But guess what? Who's making that commit? I haven't actually configured my, if I'm working with Git locally on my machine, I actually need to configure who I am. One thing I can do is I can say git config dash list, I believe. And this is all the various settings of things that are like set up. I don't really care about that. And I just hit Q to get out of that. What I need to do, and I'm just going to look this up, it's like git config user dot name, or user email, or username. Like this can be my name, or whatever name I want. Usually you should just probably tie this to your GitHub account. It needs to be global. Git config username. I want it to be global. I think if I do dash dash global. And then I could say git config user.email, Daniel at thecodingtrain.com dash dash global. So this now, I've now set up Git, by the way. If it's a fresh install, you're going to want to do this with my information. And then I can do things like, I can say git status. And this is like the new untracked file. So I can say git add sketch.js. And then I can commit it. And maybe what I want to do is say, most people would just do this, git commit dash m for a short message, like make a new file. And I could do that, but I'm being very long-winded in this video. So what I'm actually going to do is configure my editor. So what I'm going to look for is configure code editor with git, or like associate, I think it's the word I'm looking for, associate. And if I come here, basically this is what I need. Git config dash dash global core, I want this. And then I'm using code. And I think it's good like to put this dash dash wait, meaning it'll wait till you finish. And now if I say just git commit, it opened up this thing in my editor, which I can now write my commit message, new file. And I can write my longer one like dear diary, I don't know what I am doing with my life. All the best, Chief Mon. All right, and then once I close it, back here, it's done that. And now, by the way, I don't know why I'm talking about git branches, but I can say git branch source, and I can now say that made a new branch. Like I can say git branch, and it'll list me, and I hit Q to get out of that. Git branch dash V. It's showing me more information. And I can say git checkout source. And now I'm in the source branch. So this is so useful. If you're, you know, again, if you're new to Git, you might not realize this, but knowing which branch you're in all the time, having that reminder, is incredibly useful. So I should also mention, if I go back into Visual Studio Code and I do things like add something, you know, create canvas 200, you can see here, there's ways, here you can see right here, this one comes up. So this is also, Visual Studio Code knows about Git and is showing you things like there's been, I think, one change. And if I click on this here, it's kind of showing me like, oh, this is the new line of code. That is the current change. And you can actually do all of your Git stuff from within Visual Studio Code yourself, but I tend to do it here. Something that is a little tricky is if you want to not have to always type in your username and password for GitHub, if you're about to send your code to GitHub, there's a way to configure that through an SSH key. Maybe I'll try, I think it makes sense to do that in a separate video if people are interested in that, but the instructions are actually pretty good on the GitHub website, SSH key GitHub. Like if I go to this generating a new SSH key, I always am just like following this exactly and then associating it with a particular laptop, and then that computer is automatically logged in. And you know, you should probably use a passphrase when it asks you, empty for no passphrase, but that'll keep it more secure. Okay, all right, so next up, working with Node. Oh, we're almost done.